this afternoon, we concentrate on Ladies' Day because all three medals will be decided in the women's singles, and of course the gold medal match in the women's doubles as well. And the players making their way onto courts for the bronze medal playoff match. And it's India's Saina Nehwal, the number four seed here at the Olympic Games, up against the number two seed, Wang, the left-handed Chinese player. Of course, we know that the final is a Chinese affair. China have never made a clean sweep of medals in women's singles, despite their overwhelming dominance in this discipline in world badminton. For Saina Nehwal, she's trying to become only the second Indian woman to win an Olympic medal. Kanam Maleswari, 18 years ago in Atlanta in 1996, won a bronze medal in the weightlifting 68 kilo division. Can Saina Nehwal win a second? We're about to find out as we look at the left-handed Wang Sin. There is the 22-year-old who lives in Hyderabad in India, competing in her second Olympic Games. Quarterfinalist 4 years ago. In fact, she became the first Indian to reach an Olympic quarterfinal. Here she is now this year playing for a medal, a bronze medal. Well, this probably one of the most difficult matches that players ever have to compete in. You've lost an Olympic semi-final, and you have to pick yourself up after the disappointment of that and come out a day later to try and salvage something from your Olympic appearance. Well, Saina Nehwal, yesterday losing her semi-final to the number one seed, Wang Yihan. There you can see two straight games. It was 21-13, 21-13. And prior to that semi-final encounter, she hadn't dropped a game all tournament. Of course, women's singles here at the Olympic Games started with 46 players divided into 16 groups. Everybody played everyone else within the group, and then the top of the group went through to the knockout stage, which started at the round of 16. Wang Sin, well, surprise loss in a way yesterday in her semi-final when she lost the number three seed Li Shurui in two straight games. What a battle she had, though, in her quarterfinal against the number nine seed, the 17-year-old from Thailand, Intanon Ratchanuk. She was a game and 9-16 down in the second before she battled back to win in an hour and 4 minutes. I'm Joe Clark, and I'm delighted to say that I'm joined here for these medal matches in the women's singles by former Australian player Peter Blackburn. And Peter, this is difficult for the players, these bronze medal matches, but a necessity.
Oh, definitely. You have to play off to win the bronze medal. And these two ladies, they'll just have to shut that out of their mind, their previous matches. They've both got very good fighting qualities, and they need to come out here and show their best. It's a very big occasion for both of them.
Max Bates from Germany, umpire for this match. So the women's singles bronze medal playoff, Wang Sin, the left-hander, the number two seed, who was surprisingly beaten in the semi-final. Far side of the court, Saina Nehwal of India. What a good opening rally. Missed it. Well, I can tell you that the whole of India came to a standstill yesterday, watching Saina Nehwal in her semi-final encounter against the number one seed, Wang Yihan. She said afterwards that she was bitterly disappointed, that she'd been a little bit nervous. But if there's one really, really outstanding quality with this young lady, it's her fighting spirit. Missed another one. Well, this is actually the seventh meeting between these two players of the previous six. Wang Sin holds the advantage, having won four of them. But I suspect the most important time they met was the last occasion they played each other, which was in the Super Series finals at the end of last year. And Saina Nehwal won in two straight games. This is the ideal start for the Indian number one.
It certainly is, Jill, and both players have really come out firing. You're playing the four corners of the court, not holding back on their shots, so they're really keen to take out this medal, both of them.
Now, you can see Wang Sin just adjusting that back support. There has been talk this week of how she's struggling with a back injury. It has been an ongoing problem, I have to say, because when she was 17 years of age, she joined the National Training Center in Beijing, and after just 2 months, she picked up a very serious back injury and therefore was sent back to her province, Liaoning, in northeast coast of China. And then, having recovered from the back injury, she then continued to train with her provincial team. And it was only in 2009 that she got back into the national squad. Oh, plenty of Indian support here at Wembley. Oh, that's a nice angle. Plenty of Chinese support too, but I think at the moment Indian supporters have been a little more vocal.
Well, they certainly have, and it's a good start by Saina Nehwal too, so she's pleasing her fans.
Wilson, a little bit nervous at the moment. There's Edwin Indrawan and Bulela Gopichand, Indian coaches.
Lovely play by Wang Sin. Just holding the shuttle there and deceiving Saina Nehwal.
Oh, that's long too, so Wang Sin back level. Five different nations have ever taken medals in the women's singles discipline here at the Olympic Games. China, Indonesia, Korea, Denmark and the Netherlands. Saina Nehwal absolutely desperate to make it six different countries to have medaled in Olympic women's singles competition. Oh, it's another good rally. And Peter just explained to us the usual tactics of singles, which are very different in essence to the tactics of doubles.
Well, yeah, definitely. Look, you're wanting to move your opponent around to the four corners of the court, get them off that center base, get them to hit the shuttle off balance. And really, if they can get in on the front court when they get the short lift, just as Wang Xing did then they need to capitalize on it.
Yes, and I do think that women's singles is becoming more and more like men's singles in that the control of the front of the court, as you've mentioned, is becoming absolutely paramount.
Shuttle right on the line.
That's a very, very good spell by Wang Xin. Seven of the last 8 points going her way.
You could see with Wang Xin, she was really going for her shots right from the outset. She made a few errors, but that didn't deter her. And she's definitely trying to command the front court.
And that's just long. Oh my goodness me. Incredible shot. Well, exemplifying what you were talking about tactics wise Peter, outmaneuvering her opponent, playing to all four corners of the court, deep in the forehand corner, then making Saina Nehwal try and move to the backhand net, and Nehwal unable to get there.
Yeah, she's in the full diagonal of the court. She's been placing it up into that, tacking up to that forehand corner, which has been working well for Wang Xing.
Well, it was such a promising start, wasn't it, to this opening game by Saina Nehwal. 5-2 up. And then her opponent, left-handed Wang Xing, promptly winning 9 of the next 10 points to have this 5-point advantage at the mid-game interval. Oh, it's called good. Wow, 10 of 11 points now.
Well, definitely the momentum's all going her way, but you could see just after that mid-interval, Saina Nehwal was starting to try and force the play a little bit more. She seemed to direct it. She needs to do that.
Oh, perfect net shot. Yeah, and it was the perfect net play from the left-hander Wang Xin that did the damage.
She certainly is stepping in with a lot of confidence, isn't she? Commanding that front court.
Yeah, this is extraordinary. And that's out 12 of 13 points from 2-5 down. That's good judgment. good rally. And finally, that run comes to an end. Saina Nehwal was in absolutely tremendous form coming into these Olympic Games. Last two tournaments she played, she won Thailand Grand Prix and the Indonesia Premier Super Series event in Indonesia. She beat two Chinese players back to back. Li Xuerui, who of course is in the gold medal match later on, and also Wang Shoxian. That's unbelievable. Well, there is the former Olympic champion, Jiang Ning. Only singles player to have retained a title that she first won in Athens and then again 4 years ago in Beijing.
It's a terrific record, isn't it? Terrific performance.
Overdone it. Well, the amount of court that both these players are covering is quite remarkable. Me, it's a good rally. Oh my goodness, net cords, court coverage. That's unbelievable. Well, badminton of the very, very highest quality. India's golden bird. Shuttle, of course, often referred to as the bird in badminton.
That was a wonderful rally, wasn't it? I'm sure all those pre-match nerves now are totally out of their system. Both players have been working very hard. One thing, you can see that she's really attacking that forehand deep corner a lot of the time. And she's just got to be careful that she doesn't overplay that, because Saina Nehwal, I believe she's starting to read that tactic. Just overplaying that one. But you can see she's always pushing up to that deep forehand corner of Saina Nehwal.
Do you perceive that as a weakness then for Nehwal?
I would have said that they've probably gone out with a plan that, yes, they're going to drag her across there, and they've used the diagonal cross court very effectively. Wong Sing has, she's really stretched her to the four corners of the court, but especially that diagonal from the forehand to her backhand.
It's gone wide.
Either it's a weakness or there's a, they've quite fearful of the strength of her around the headshot and on the backhand side of the court.
I suppose the other reason for hitting down the right-hander's forehand side is that she's more likely to then play straight, which of course is onto the forehand of the left-hander.
Very true.
Well, Saina Nehwal moving her feet so quickly there. Be able to play that round the head shot, as we call it. When it's played down, a player's black backhand side, but they still play with the normal overhead action. Just wide. Well, Wang Sim appears not to like the call. I instinctively thought it was a correct call, but we'll be able to see it again. Yep, just wide. Judging. Another one's gone wide, and I think that Wang Sin is struggling physically. A couple of times she's been bent double after the rally. I don't know whether it's because her back is sore or whether she's out of breath. Can't believe she'd be out of breath. She's such a fit athlete. Of deep gulps of air, though.
Well, sometimes, Jill, that's a bit of nervous tension too, which really does drain the players. So it's not all just about the physical work on the court, it's also about the mental toughness and endurance that they must have, especially over a competition such as this over a week.
Extraordinary angle. Well, when you see her play a shot like that, it's really not altogether surprising, is it, that she's got a bad back? The way she arches her back, almost contorting her body to get herself in position to play that. And here, 6 game point opportunities. Oh, my goodness. What disguise. Again. And then Saina Nehwal is commanding the rallies. when she's lunging forward and taking it early at the front of the court, as you were suggesting, was so important. Really puts a different complexion on the rallies, doesn't it?
It certainly does. And if as you were saying, fitness may come a part of this game, then as she steps forward and gets her confidence and she starts directing the play, it can really change things very quickly.
Third game point opportunity for Wang Sin. Oh, that's landed well in. And third time that it's saved by the Indian number one. So three game point opportunities for Wang Sin have come and gone. And another three remain. But that's wide as well. And oh my goodness, what's happened? I didn't like that at all. She's in terrible pain. I think it might be her Achilles. Oh dear, oh dear. Oh my goodness me. Tournament doctor has arrived on court. Did you see that, Pete? Was it the ankle that went, or was it?
Well, the way he's moving, it looks as if it is the lower part of the ankle, but she went down so quickly, didn't she?
Dear me. What a tragedy. We hate to see injuries in any sport. Well, of course, the rules of badminton mean that the tournament doctor can assess, but he can't treat. We've also got the tournament referee, Torsten Berg. Well, you can see that there's an ankle strap there anyway. Oh, dear, dear me. Well, we've seen one ruptured Achilles tendon earlier this week with Polish player Mikhail Logosz.
You can see she's just gone straight off that foot. She's taken the weight off it as soon as she came back down on it. That's definitely her ankle.
Well, you really have to be in top four for medal matches. Well, in all honesty, this is a little bit of a shambles, isn't it, Peter? I mean, the coaches and support staff of Wang Sin officially are not allowed onto court at this moment.
And you think the ref is there, and he definitely knows the rules.
Well, oh, it was the knee. It was the knee.
Wow, the way that she came down on that ankle, it looked as if as soon as she put the weight on it.
Wow. What on earth? Well, I mean, from a spectator's point of view, which is what you and I both are, we want to see a match.
Certainly do.
And therefore, even so, it's technically against the rules. We would love to see her being able to play on. But, on the other hand, let's spare a thought for Saina Nehwal. Saina Nehwal knows the rules, and the fact that both her coaches are on court, both of them talking, and certainly Chinese fans looking very anxious indeed. It's all been happening this week, hasn't it, at Wembley Arena. Controversy earlier on. Well, I have to say, I find that in a way quite bizarre.
Well, Well, the thing that has done it has really broken that momentum from Saina Nehwal as well. She had a great run on her serve there.
It's still game point, and she's taken the game. Well, well, well. 21-18. And my sympathies, I have to say, are leaning a little bit towards Saina Nehwal.
Well, you don't want to see an injury from either player.
No. No, I totally support that. As we see confirmation of the opening game score, 21-18 in favour of the number two seed, Wang Sin. But correct me if I'm wrong here, Peter, but I thought the rules of badminton were that coaches couldn't come on during the game, only at the mid-game intervals, only in between games that the doctor could assess, but he wasn't supposed to treat. Perhaps the rules are different during the Olympics. I know those are the rules during most of the BWF, the Badminton World Federation, sanctioned events.
Yeah, so that's how I understand it, Jill, and you know, that's what the doctor's there for. His job is to go out to assess the player and whether they can go on. So very surprising that they allowed that to happen. It's such an important stage,
crucial,
of the game as well.
Yeah, game points. Well, as far as Saina Nehwal is concerned, there's head Chinese coach Li Yongbo keeping his distance. As far as Saina Nehwal is concerned, she somehow has to put that out of her mind. If she believes her opponent is injured, sometimes you change your tactics, perfectly legitimate. It's not been unsportsmanlike to try and maneuver your opponent and push them to all four corners a little bit more than previously, but sometimes if you change your tactics, it's not necessarily a good idea.
Yeah, she has to be careful there, but I think there's a lot of positive signs from her game personally towards the end of that first game. She had a good run on. Oh, she's down again.
No, this is... She's just indicating, no, she can't play.
That's very sad, isn't it?
Oh, it's tragic. No, enough is enough. Her knee has gone, I think.
Very sad circumstances.
Well, I think the tournament referee, Torsten Berg, has said that she must withdraw.
Enough's enough. She seems in a lot of pain as well.
Well, somebody needs to make clear what is happening. And Saina Nehwal standing in the background, helping her.
That's it. It's over.
Well, nice to see the players embrace at the end. Well, that is absolutely tragic. Saina Nehwal will indeed be awarded the bronze medal, but I can assure you, knowing Saina Nehwal personally, that's not the way she would have wanted to win. One of the saddest things, I think, at any sporting venue is seeing a player carried off for having to withdraw injured. But for Saina Nehwal, in a way, it's a dream of an Olympic medal. But how tragic that it's happened in this way. Well, a premature end, a match that had promised so much. 21-18. She had won the first game. And right at the start of the second, had to withdraw with that knee injury. But it does mean that Saina Nehwal will be awarded the bronze medal. And so a sixth nation at badminton's women's singles will pick up a medal in the badminton competition.